Ever since the death of their teenage leader, the Phantom Thieves have fallen silent. However, the police intend on continuing this investigation until the case is fully solved.
I'm sorry I'm late. I had to finish a few things at work. Where are they?
Waiting upstairs. Go tell them to come on down. I'm gonna fetch him.
You're her sister, correct?
Makoto told me everything. Futaba-chan, I'm sorry that I caused you so much trouble this past summer.
It's ancient history now.
Man, that goddamn detective!
Look who's here.
Hey, you big bastard!
How've you been? You must be fine if you're joking around like that. It truly is a relief to see your face.
I bet that moron Akechi don't even know we tricked him yet.
Still, how'd you pull this off? Isn't this guy considered dead?
You weren't told anything? I heard my sister brought him here, though.
Yeah, she came over in a taxi, dumped him off, and told me to keep him safe. It was right after they announced he had died, too. Almost gave me a heart attack.
I didn't have time to explain.
Hey, shouldn't we tell Boss what really happened?
We wanted to make our enemy believe the leader of the Phantom Thieves was dead.
What?
What we did was make that enemy kill his fake in the metaverse.
Hold on a sec. Enemy? Fake? What are you talking about?
The true culprit behind all these incidents set us up. Our goal here was to determine their identity.
True culprit? I see. So you guys were going up against someone else.
It was Goro Akechi. You knew beforehand that he was the traitor, didn't you?
Akechi himself gave us the chance to strike back. He made one fatal mistake.
Couldn't you have just said from the beginning that Akechi was the real culprit?
That wasn't something we could simply bring up. We couldn't have you suspect Akechi. Besides, neither you nor the other investigators would have believed something like that, would you?
True. Akechi was credited with the arrest of the Phantom Thieves. Not even I would think he was the culprit. In other words, you left him alone on purpose. That was a bold move.
God, I can't keep up with any of this stuff. So what was this mistake Akechi made? What did he do?
He slipped up in regards to Morgana's voice.
You mean a cat?
Yes, Morgana can talk.
Sorry, was that supposed to be a joke?
Oh, our apologies. That's completely true. You surprised?
Does that mean he said something just now as well?
But you don't understand him, do you? That's how it was for all of us at first, too.
When you're in the metaverse, Mona talks like a normal person. Once you hear that and your brain realizes he can actually talk, you start to understand him in reality. It's a change in cognition, most likely.
Thanks to Akechi's lame acting, we figured out something was up.
When we talked to Akechi at the school festival, he was acting like he just realized Mona could talk. But we already saw him drop a mega hint about it way earlier.
Oh, I know a place! I want to go to that huge pancake-looking place we passed on the way here!
Oh, am I mistaken? I thought I heard something about delicious pancakes.
Mona was the only one who was talking about a pancake. That meant Akechi'd already been in the metaverse by then.
And since he was lying to us about that, we assumed he had a hidden motive behind contacting us.
It seemed odd upon further thought. His reaction to my pancake comment was an honest one, after all. That said, we weren't so naive to overlook something like that.
That's why we asked Futaba-chan to wiretap his phone.
I pretended to be interested in checking the phone out, but I was actually planting my app. My heart was pounding while I was doing it, though.
Even that ace detective could never have imagined a program being installed so quickly. Futaba's quirky nature proved to be a great help.
That was just an act!
After a few days of listening, this confirmed his betrayal.
Then I'll guide the police into her palace and have them catch the Phantom Thieves in the act. That would be the only way to arrest them, given their methods. I'll deal with them after that. Let me see. We could say he stole the guard's gun and committed suicide during his imprisonment. How about that? Public security questioning will occur on the first day. And with that room, my task will be simple.
Is this for real?
Yes, the guard will be one of ours. We'll have to eliminate him after to destroy the evidence, though.
So they plan to get rid of that guard from the beginning.
Well then, I will make the arrangements the day after the arrest. And thus, the dangerous criminal responsible for the mass mental shutdowns shall end his own life. When he does, you will become a great hero who saved Japan from evil. As will I, of course.
I knew he was acting strangely, but to think he was this far gone...
He's no ace detective. Akechi is the perpetrator behind the mental shutdown crimes.
On top of that, there's someone else commanding Akechi. Someone with great authority. So great that they can order an assassination in a police station. That's why we had to make a move before they did.
I see.
We baited Akechi into Sis's palace, making him dispose of our leader's fake, but think he killed him.
Can you elaborate on that in more detail? What exactly happened in my cognitive world?
We're sorry for using you without your permission. Your palace had all the conditions we needed.
What conditions?
First, we required a place inside the cognitive world that was the same as in reality.
That place is based on the real world after all. Anywhere that's not warped looks just like normal.
That's why nobody but the person who uses the nav even realizes they're in the metaverse.
Back with Kamoshida, we came in from the station without even noticing. You totally can't tell the difference if there ain't any distortions around.
We had already investigated Nijima-san's palace when Makoto brought the suggestion to us.
I was seriously impressed by that suggestion. To be honest, I didn't quite understand it, but I went along with it. Yeah, it's good we have her heading up our operations.
Makoto is normally so calm as well, but once her mind is set, she gets oddly impulsive.
I did have a bit of a rivalry forming with Akechi, but I just couldn't contain myself anymore once you became a target, sis. The reason I joined the Phantom Thieves was to heal your heart, after all.
My own achievements were all that mattered to me. I was desperate. I wasn't myself at all. I'm sorry I couldn't see that.
That goes for the both of us.
We heard from Mako-chan that you were going to do the interrogation, Nijima-san.
And regarding its location, I take it you used the data from my laptop?
I'm sorry.
Go on.
There were two things we were able to confirm while we were checking the metaverse. First, our clothes didn't change when we were down in the interrogation room. Second, the scenery and details outside of the palace proper were the same as in the real world.
Once we heard that from Makoto, we secretly went to check it out without Akechi knowing.
There was also one more thing we absolutely needed to make this work. A perfect cognitive replica of him in the metaverse's interrogation room.
Since he had yet to be caught, though, there obviously wouldn't be anyone in that room.
Once we saw the casino guests and police officers, we were convinced this would work. They looked no different from actual living people.
After that, we just had to work our way into the palace like usual, while keeping Akechi in the dark.
Everything went as planned up until we defeated Sis's shadow. However, it was then that we were met with a terrifying, unexpected police ambush. As a result, even though we managed to grab the treasure, we couldn't get it out of the metaverse. Except that was all an act. We had prepared an empty briefcase beforehand and merely acted like we were taking the treasure. This was because we knew the police would be coming for us.
We made sure before the operation that the police would be waiting to ambush us. And just as expected, he totally took the bait.
Him getting captured by the police went exactly how we planned it.
And I had been interrogating him with no knowledge of this. But how did you lure Akechi into this cognitive world's interrogation room?
All I needed were the coordinates.
Akechi disposed of the fake in the palace and left thinking he had been victorious. It must have been truly hilarious for our leader who sat idly in the real world's interrogation room. Surely he was acting quite cocky by himself in that quiet chamber.
So that's why you gave me your phone. I only took it because of what you told me.
That's a shame I didn't have the opportunity to see that for myself.
All I could do was try to handle all the messages that started coming to me on his phone. Huh. So in other words, I've been to the Metaverse, albeit for a brief moment.
In our experience, there is little danger when someone enters their own palace for so short a time.
That's the other reason we had him give it to you. We needed you to listen to Alibaba, deceive the guard, and ultimately aid in his escape. By having you head back to the interrogation room, we could return you to the real world as well.
I mean, I had to think of some way to keep you from running into Akechi mid-assassination.
Huh. Astounding. I hadn't the slightest idea that such a grand operation was taking place within me.
I'm so glad he was able to persuade you during the interrogation. Even though we knew Akechi's plan, we were pretty worried about that part.
True.
Why is that?
Without Sis on our side, Futaba's plan and subsequent breakout would have never been possible. That persuasion was easily our greatest gamble. We couldn't consult Sis beforehand. It was absolutely the make-or-break moment of the entire plan.
Still, I'm surprised you could convince me in such a short time. Were you confident you could do it? I see. Either way, I can't believe you went for such a risky idea.
If we could just tell you the true culprit's plan, I knew you'd realize the bigger picture. Realize that our leader was telling the truth, and that there was a greater evil to pursue.
As a result, we emerged victorious.
Then the reason you kept this a secret from me was so you could catch the true culprit, correct?
Yes. Plus, you had lost control of yourself at the time.
This is stunning. All I can really do is laugh.
I've kind of figured out that you guys made Akechi kill a fake. But what did you do about the body?
The police never even checked it.
Huh?
They had a coroner working to ensure his death was reported as a suicide. That coroner didn't take one look at the scene and just passed along a falsified death certificate.
The bad guys have that much influence?
Murder in a police station would be reckless otherwise. We also knew of a possible conspirator.
Thanks to Futaba-chan's messages and the guard's demeanor, I eventually came to understand. And since the higher-ups at the police knew nothing of this, they were thrown into disarray. As a result, his suicide during imprisonment was reported on the news, just as Akechi planned.
And with that confusion, he was able to escape with Nijima-san's help.
I made sure nobody would check the morgue for his body, and thanks to that, nobody knows he survived.
Thinking back to the interrogation, though, I can't believe what they did to him. The callous use of violence, and even drugs, is utterly abnormal. If he had lost consciousness and hadn't been able to tell Sis about the phone, he would have died. I'm truly glad you made it back safe.
How tough are you?
It still freaked me out when I saw the suicide on the news, though.
We made sure to live normal lives while he was being interrogated to avoid drawing any suspicion. Even with that, I couldn't help but worry for him in my heart.
Well, I knew right away that her plan worked out.
I wanted to believe, but considering what we were up against...
Ryuji's a bit on the dense and carefree side.
Can it, Kat?
I had to be patient and avoid this place until things settled down. I finally feel relieved.
We knew he was alive, but it was difficult to not worry until we could confirm it in person.
Now that I think about it, my interrogation was just a formality for the head commander. What a joke, letting me interrogate someone who was meant to die. They just wanted to avoid backlash. Very well. From here forward, I will do my utmost to assist you. You saved me, after all.
That's reassuring to hear.
I'll do whatever I can to help, too. Just let me know. Let's take a break for now, though. This old brain is pooped. Oh, and feel free to use the first floor when you guys want to get together to talk. You'll need a hideout where you can be safe. Just say the word, and I'll close shop early.
Are you sure?
This guy can't leave. Plus, you won't make much progress if people can hear you from downstairs. It's not like this place is the liveliest joint in town. It won't be a huge loss for me.
Let us accept his offer. What a great man.
That sounds familiar.
It's me, Akechi.
Enter.
That's the death certificate of the principal offender, correct? Is there a problem with it?
No, nothing in particular. More importantly, you've done well with regard to the prosecutors.
The cause of death for the SIU director has been settled as a stroke.
I had him work quite substantially on forging evidence. His loss should be mourned.
It was thanks to his efforts that I could enter the Phantom Thieves interrogation room, too.
The SIU is in disarray with his death. I'll take my time choosing a successor after the elections.
At any rate, I'm now praised as a hero, and I owe it all to the Phantom Thieves.
All possible hindrances are now gone. There's no doubt that this election is mine.
And on to our next story, the snap election for the House of Representatives. Discussion is swirling around potential nominees as the deadline for candidacy announcement nears. Candidates will announce on the 23rd of this month, while voting will be held on the 18th of next.
Elections, huh? Don't matter to us. It's not like we can vote in him yet anyways.
Why don't we resume our conversation?
Well, the Phantom Thieves are back together! We can finally take it to Akechi and the bastard backing him!
Have you figured out who's behind all this?
Akechi accidentally let that slip after the murder. He said, Shido-san.
Shido? Feels like I've heard that somewhere.
He is unmistakably a man of power if he has such strong connections to the police.
Shido? Could it be Masayoshi Shido?
Who? I believe he's a politician. Remember Ryuji? You said his speech was too loud.
For real?
It's certainly possible that Shido is the mastermind.
Huh?
Do you have some kind of evidence?
Nothing material. However, there are various conditions which align with that possibility. First, he would profit from damage done to the current administration by the psychotic breakdowns. He's maintained a negative stance toward the Phantom Thieves and has gained tremendous popularity. On top of that, he'll most likely become the next Prime Minister if he wins this upcoming election.
No!
Did he set us up with that election in mind?
If he is behind all this, that would be in stark opposition to his honest public image.
So his current position and popularity is just him benefiting from the mental collapses. We'll make him have a change of heart, no matter what it takes. Mom.
Shido, huh?
What is the matter?
I had a feeling he was wrapped up in all this, just based on the connections I had from my previous job. I think the one who crushed Wakaba's research and confiscated her materials was probably Shido. From the moment Wakaba died, I had a hunch he was involved. But there wasn't anything I could do, so I chose to protect Futaba and went into hiding.
Why didn't you say that sooner?
You guys would have definitely gone after him if I had. He would have just killed all of you, no doubt. That's what he usually does to people who get in his way.
Originally, I was looking into the mental shutdown cases. It was then that I accidentally stumbled upon government research regarding the psychotic breakdowns. So, I tracked down the whereabouts of that research data and met with the associated parties. Boss was one of those parties. I would never have imagined all of this was connected. The mental shutdowns, psychotic breakdowns, Shido, and even the Phantom Thieves' actions.
Way back when, Shido kept saying he was going to be Prime Minister one day. Nobody believed him, though.
What's going to happen to this country if Shido becomes Prime Minister? What about the world?
The The issue is simpler than that. This is nothing more than yet another selfish adult trying to impose his will on the public.
We gotta expose that rotten bastard!
Yeah, we'll do it like always. Then let's check the nav.
Masayoshi Shido, the guy running for Prime Minister.
Result found.
Got a hit! Well, duh. Ain't a surprise he has one.
Where would the location be?
What kind of things go through a politician's head?
I always think of dirty money and shady actions.
What does he do? And where? We don't got a clue about this guy's life.
His palace must be somewhere that politicians frequent. Any ideas?
We got a hit!
How arrogant must he be to see himself as the ruler of the Diet Building?
Our next target's the big-shot politician Masayoshi Shido. We're gonna do this, right? No need to waste time with him, we just gotta hit the head. Nobody against it?
Of course!
He will be a worthy opponent.
Let's win this together!
Time for revenge!
Then it's unanimous!
All we gotta do now is figure out what he thinks that Diet Building place is.
So that's the app that allowed me to enter the Metaverse.
An old fart like me can't wrap his head around all this stuff.
We'll have to deal with this before Election Day, December 18th. That means we need it done by the 17th.
It's best we hurry before they discover there's no body in the morgue.
Should we start tomorrow then? We can meet at the Diet Building after school.
That reminds me. What are you gonna do about school? You can't show up if you're supposed to be dead.
Miss Kawakami said he went back home for family reasons.
That's what I told the school.
Don't let him find out you're alive then, alright? This whole thing would be for nothing.
What do you mean?
This operation had another purpose outside of escaping Akechi's clutches. Shido tried to place all the blame on the Phantom Thieves and deceive the public at the same time. He has ruined countless lives, and even made Goro Akechi, a student, assist him with assassinations. A mere change of heart is too lenient a sentence for such an abominable criminal.
We'll be making use of the police statement that the leader of the Phantom Thieves committed suicide. Our leader, who is presumed dead, will come out of hiding to deliver a grand statement. He'll say he has escaped prison, not committed suicide, and was in fact almost killed by a criminal.
Everyone's gonna flip.
You guys thought through all this stuff too?
We're intellectuals, you know.
That's why you needed such a daring trick as getting captured and appearing to be killed. What frightening teenagers.
But the true battle has only just begun. We won the first round, but we must stay on our toes.
Yeah, this ain't the time to be celebrating.
These people tried to trap and kill us. There is no end to their inhuman, conniving nature. We will need to be prepared for whatever may come our way.
I finally made it this far. It's already been 2.5 years since we met.
Back then, you earned the media's attention as a young politician who could rise up against bureaucracy. Because of that, those who wanted to preemptively deal with problems tried to tie you up in scandal.
To think I would fall for the ruse schemed by those decrepit fools in power. I recall that's when you came to me. You promoted yourself saying you had special powers. If it wasn't for the research on cognition that I dabbled in, I would have thought you insane.
I made those troublesome opponents psychotic, and erased any trace of that scandal.
Who'd think that tampering with a person's heart could trigger a psychotic lapse or mental shutdown? And when someone like that said he'd support me, I had suspected there'd be an ulterior motive.
It's because I sympathized with your aspiring ideology. I believed that your ideals needed to be achieved for the sake of the country's future.
Well, my faith in you was precisely why I pulled the plug on that research. I only need you using that power. It'd be troublesome if someone else uncovered how it works.
Wakaba Ishiki, was it? That researcher, she wouldn't have had to die if she just complied.
Any suspicions should be snubbed out. Even the smallest doubt must be severed at the root. After all, we had an active public prosecutor's office director on our side until recently.
Astounding, isn't it? To think the director himself often forged evidence to secure his promotion. He was quite surprised when you confronted him about it. He didn't know who leaked that information. Well, I got that out of his shadow, so technically speaking, he did it himself.
This country's affairs have become stagnant. The political world is filled with old men who only act to preserve their own vested interests. The general public has forsaken such political affairs and don't even bother. Only ruin awaits us.
I must agree.
There's no need to be ruined along with such incompetent fools. I will lead this country to its revival. Those who get in the way must be eliminated at times. That's the correct way to use the metaverse.
Still, it would stand out if there were continuous deaths and scandals with your political rivals. Which is why I made them suspects. Prosecute the targets that I turn psychotic, and solve them as cases unrelated to you. And thus, the charismatic Ace Detective was born.
Thanks to your efforts, my clean image remains untarnished, and I've monopolized public opinion. Once I gained public sentiment, collaborators from all sectors began approaching me on their own. The police were no exception. With their management in my pocket, keeping them in check was easy.
When the Phantom Thieves emerged, I thought things might become somewhat troublesome.
And they were just brats once we looked into it. All we needed to do was lay the blame on them.
When you told me that, I knew then that you were the better man.
Their popularity was a bit beyond my expectations. But flipping it made the negative press stronger. After that, all I had to do was openly berate them. I've been gaining more supporters since. The current administration is dead with ongoing scandals. Never mind the fact that they're my doing. Even the government parties have begun splitting up, and they're dissolving just as planned. The time has finally come. Just a little more, and I will take the seat of Prime Minister. However, inauguration isn't my goal. That's when everything truly begins. I'll make this country rich for the sake of its selfish and ignorant masses who can only rely on others.
In other words, you're creating a powerful country that can compete with the world.
The public resonates with my ideals and follows me. And for that, some sacrifices can't be avoided. That is my duty as the chosen one. Your assistance has been very influential in making my plans proceed smoothly. When I become Prime Minister, I'll grant whatever wish you want.
With this most recent case, my name has become known across the country, perhaps even the world. Surely my story will be passed down as a hero who won against monsters that could control people's hearts. I believe I'll lay low and devote myself to my studies.
I suppose with your age, you wouldn't come up with debauched desires.
I am thinking about the future, though.
Guess he won't be going to school for a while. Don't worry about it. This'll be a breeze compared to what we've had to face so far. And we'll have all the time to come up with the plans together. To be perfectly honest, I don't really care what happens to Shido, one way or the other, but when I consider the fact that he's your enemy, I naturally think he's my enemy as well. I'm going to stay with you until the very end.
Well, how do I put this?
Well then.
Where have you been?
Mm-hmm.